Hello students, in this video we are going to see the topics light and the electromagnetic spectrum, representing digital images and spatial and intensity resolution. So let's start from the light and the electromagnetic spectrum. The electromagnetic spectrum is the term used by scientists to describe the entire range of light that exists. From radio waves to gamma rays, most of the light in the universe is in fact invisible to us. So light is a wave of alternating electric and magnetic fields. Electromagnetic radiation is the type of energy that includes light, heat and X-rays. It can be described using sinusoidal wave model, where the properties of the radiation depend on the wavelength, frequency and other parameters of the wave. For some purposes, it makes more sense to describe the energy as a stream of light particles, which are known as photons, where the energy of photons is proportional to the frequency of the radiation. Wave properties of electromagnetic radiations are: amplitude, which is denoted by A, the height of the wave. Then wavelength, which is denoted by lambda, the distance between two crests of the wave. Here is the one crest and second, here is the second crest. So crest and trough, so the highest and lowest points respectively of a wave, right? Then speed of light, which is denoted by C, the velocity of radiation. Here, so it is the velocity of the radiation as it travels through a vacuum. So this quantity is the same for all forms of electromagnetic radiation, from X-rays to light to radio waves, and it constant within a particular transportation medium. The speed of the light in vacuum is 2.99792 × 10⁸ msec. So the speed of light in the air is only 0.03% slower, and C in either medium is usually just rounded off to 3 × 10⁸ msec. Now the frequency, right? The frequency V, the number of waves that pass a fixed point per second. Period, which is denoted by T, so the number of seconds it takes for a wave to pass a fixed point. V is equal to 1 by T, which is the frequency of the wave, is the reciprocal of the period. Lambda V equal to C, or we can say that V equal to C by lambda. The product of frequency and wavelength is the speed of light. Alternatively, the frequency of a wave is inversely proportional to the velocity. E equal to HV equal to HC by lambda, where H is a Planck constant, 6.626 × 10⁻³. The energy of the radiation is equal to the Planck constant multiplied by the frequency of the radiation. V is equal to 1 by T, which is the frequency of wave in a reciprocal of the period, right? So in 1666, Sir Isaac Newton discovered that when a beam, means sunbeam of sunlight, is passed through a glass prism, the emerging beam, means a developed beam of light, is not white but be made up of, instead of, a continuous spectrum of colors ranging from violet at one end to the red at the other. All waves of electromagnetic radiation travel at the speed of light. Different types of waves have vastly differing wavelengths, frequencies and energies. the shorter the wavelength of the radiation, the greater the frequency and the larger the energy. So the electromagnetic spectrum ranges from gamma radiation, which has the shortest wavelength, highest frequency and greatest energy, to the radio waves, which has the longest wavelength and lowest frequency and energy. Ultraviolet light, UV, is divided into three regions. Ultraviolet A has wavelength of 400 to 320 nanometer. Ultraviolet B has wavelength of 320 to 80 nanometer. And ultraviolet C has a wavelength equal to or less than 280 nanometer. Objects appear different colors because they absorb some colors, some wavelengths, and reflected or transmit other colors. If only blue light is shown onto a red shirt, the shirt would appear black because the blue would be absorbed and there would be no red light to be reflected. So the colors that humans see in an object are determined by the nature of the light reflected, means returned from that object. A body that reflects light relatively balanced in invisible wavelengths appears white to the observer. So a body that favors reflectance in a limited range of the visible spectrum exhibits some shades of the colors. For example, green objects reflect light with wavelengths preliminarily in the 500 to 570 nanometer range while absorbing most of the energy at other wavelengths. Light that is void of color is called monochromic or achromatic light. So monochromic light, which is void of color. Monochromatic describes light that has the same wavelength, so it is one color. The only attribute of monochromic light is its intensity or amount. Because the intensity of monochromatic light is perceived to vary from black to grays and finally to white, the term gray level is used commonly to denote monochromatic intensity. Intensity is the only attribute from black to white. So the range of measured values of monochromatic light from black to white is usually called the grayscale, and monochromatic images are frequently referred to as a grayscale image. Now, chromatic light bands. So chromatic means color light spans the electromagnetic energy spectrum from approximately 0.43 in addition to frequency. So three basic measures are used to describe the quality of chromatic light source: radiance, luminance and brightness. So radiance is the total amount of energy that flows from the light source, and it is usually measured in watts, W. Luminance, measured in lumens, LM, gives a measure of the amount of energy an observer observes from the light source. For example, light emitted from a source operating in the distant infrared region of the spectrum could have significant energy, means radiance, but an observer would hardly observe it. Its luminance would be almost zero. Now, brightness is a subjective descriptor of light perception that is practically impossible to measure. It embodies the achromatic notation of intensity and is one of the key factors in describing color sensation. Now, the next topic is representing digital images. So the result of sampling and quantization is a matrix of real numbers. Assume that an image fxy, which is sampled so that the resulting digital image has m rows and n columns. So the value of the coordinates xy are discrete quantities. The values of the coordinates at the origin are xy is equal to 0, 0 The next coordinate values along the first row of the image are represented as x, y equal to 0, 1. So here is the 0, 0 and at the second point it is 0, 1. So the notation 0, 1 is used to signify the second sample along the first row. The value of the image is any at any coordinates is denoted where x and y are the integers. The section of the real plane spanned by the coordinates of an image is called a spatial domain, where x and y refer to as spatial variables or spatial coordinates. So we can see in this figure there are three basic ways to represent. Figure A is a plot of the function with have two axes defining spatial location and the third axis being the values of f as a function of the two spatial variables x and y. So while we can conclude the structure of the image in this example by looking at the plot, complex images generally are too detailed and too difficult to understand from such plots. Figure B shows as it would appear on a monitor or photograph. It is in the 2D form, right? So here the intensity of each point is relative to the value of f at that point. In this figure, there are only three equally spaced intensity values. If the intensity is normalized to the interval 0 to 1, then each point in the image has the value 0, 0.5, or 1. So a monitor or printer simply converts these three values to black, gray or white respectively. Means 0 represents the black color, 0.5 represents the gray color and 1 represents the black color. The third representation is simply to display the numerical values of an array in the form of matrix. In this example, f is of size elements or 360,000 numbers. For printing, the complete array would be weightly and take little information. So figure C conveys this concept graphically. The notation used above allows us to write the complete m cross n digital image in the following compact matrix form, which is fxy equal to f00 up to f0 n minus 1 and 2 fm minus 1 0 to fm minus 1 to n minus 1. So the right of the equation is by definition a digital image. Each element of the matrix array is called an image element, picture element, pixel or PAL. It is helpful to use a more traditional matrix notation to denote a digital image and its elements. So here we can see that Aij equal to fx, x equal to y equal to j equal to fij. So the above two matrices are identical matrices. So let z and r denoted to the set of real integers. So and the set of real numbers respectively. The sampling process may be viewed as a partitioning the xy plane into a grid with the coordinates of the center of each grid being a pair of elements from the Cartesian product z2, which is the set of all ordered pairs of elements azi, zj, b, with zi and zj being integers from z. So hence fxy is a digital image if x and y are integers from z2 and f is a function that assigns a gray level value, that is a real number from the set of real numbers r, to each distinct pair of coordinates xy. So the functional assignment is the quantization process. If the gray levels also are integers, z replaces r and digital image then becomes a 2D function whose coordinates and amplitude values are integers. So this digitization process requires decisions about values for m and n for the number l of discrete gray levels allowed for each pixel. So there are no requirements on m and n other than that they can have to be a positive integers. So due to processing, storage and sampling hardware considerations, the number of gray levels typically is an integer power of 2, so which is l equal to 2 raised to k, right? So the number b of bits required to store a m cross n digitized image, so b equal to m cross n cross k, means b is equal to m into n into k. Now spatial and intensity resolution. So spatial resolution can be started in a number of ways with line pairs per unit distance and dots, means pixels per unit distance being between the most common measures. Suppose that we construct a chart with alternating black and white vertical lines, each of width means W units, in that W can be less than 1. So the width of the line pair is accordingly 2W, and there are W line pairs per unit distance. For example, if the width of a line is 0.1 mm, then there are 5 lines of pairs per unit distance in the millimeter. So a widely used definition of image resolution is the largest number of visible line pairs per unit distance. So dots per unit distance is a measure of image resolution used commonly in the printing and publishing industry. So intensity resolution is similarly refers to the smallest visible change in the intensity level. So we have large choices regarding the number of samples used to generate a digital image, but this is not true regarding the number of intensity levels. Based on hardware considerations, the number of intensity levels are usually in an integer power of 2. So the most common numbers is 8 bits, with 16 bits being used in some applications in which improvement of specific intensity ranges is necessary. So intensity quantization using 32 bit is rare. Sometimes one finds systems that can digitize the intensity levels of the image using 10 or 12 bits. But these are the exceptions rather than the rule. The spatial resolution is common practice to refer to the number of bits used to quantize intensity as the intensity resolution. For example, it is common to say that an image whose intensity is quantized into 256 levels has 8 bits of intensity resolution, because true changes in intensities are influenced not only by noise and saturation values but also by the capabilities of human perception. Saying that an image has 8 bits of intensity resolution is nothing more than a statement regarding the ability of an 8-bit system to quantize intensity in fixed increments of 1 by 256 units of intensity amplitude. So the following examples illustrate the comparative effects of image size and intensity resolution on discernible detail. So this figure shows the effects of reducing spatial resolution in an image. The image is A through D are shown in 1250, 300 and 150 and 72 dpi respectively. Naturally, the lower resolution images are smaller than the original. For example, the original image is the size is of size pixels, but the 72 dpi image is an array of size in order to simplify compressions. All the smaller images were zoomed back into the original size. This is इक्विवेलेंट टू गेटिंग क्लोजर टू द स्मॉलर इमेजेस सो दैट वी कैन मेक कंपेरेबल स्टेटमेंट्स अबाउट विजिबल डिटेल्स. सो देर आर स्मॉल विजुअल डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन ए एंड बी, द मोस्ट नोटेबल बीइंग अ स्मॉल डिस्टोरेशन इन द इमेज ब्लैक नीडल, राइट. सो 300 dpi is the typical minimum image spatial resolution used for book publishing. Figure C begins to show the visible, right? So figure D shows the degradation that is visible in the most features of image. When printing at such low resolutions, the printing and publishing industry uses a number of tricks to produce much better results. So it is possible to improve on the results of figure by the interpolation method used. Now, in this, figure A is a city projection image displayed with k equal to 8. Images as this are acquired by fixing the X-ray source in one position, thus producing a 2D image in any desired direction. So projection images are used as guides to set up the parameters of us for a CT scanner, including tilt, number of slices and range. Figure B through H, right? So these all images are obtained by reducing the number of bits from the from to while keeping the images size constant at pixels. The 256, 128 and 64 level images are visually identical for all practical purposes. The 32 bit level image in figure D shows, however, has an invisible set of very fine edge like structures in areas of constant or nearly constant intensity. This effect caused by the use of an insufficient number of intensity levels in smooth areas of a digital image is called false. So it is known as false contouring, so called because the ridges resemble topographic contours in a map. So false contouring generally is a relatively visible in images displayed using 16 or less regularly spaced intensity levels as the images in E through H show. So as a very rough value, a very rough rule of thumb, and assuming integer powers of 2 for convenience, images of size pixels with 64 intensity levels and printed on a size format on the order of RFs or about the lowest spatial and intensity resolution images that can be expected to be reasonably free of objectionable sampling, checkboards and false contouring. Thank you.